Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Bryan Ferry has today paid an emotional tribute to his ex-wife Lucy Birley, who died suddenly on holiday in Ireland at the age of 58, just a week after fellow socialite Annabelle Nielsen passed away. Former model Mrs Birley died on Monday, surrounded by her beloved dogs, Daisy, Pig and Daphne, but it is not clear if she was with her second husband Robin, who announced her death today. Lucy and Bryan Ferry had four sons during their 21-year relationship before they divorced in 2003, having drifted apart after her long battle with addiction to drink and drugs and his workaholism. Mr. Ferry, 72, said Lucy was his musical inspiration and she appeared on the cover of his Roxy Music's eighth and final album Avalon, but she struggled with being in the spotlight and gave her last major interview in 2011. Her ex-husband said today, "I'm much saddened and shocked by this tragic news of Lucy's death. The family requests that our privacy be respected during this difficult time." After their divorce, she then married again in 2006 after finding love with Robin Birley, son of Annabelle's nightclub owner Mark Birley. Mrs. Birley's death in Ireland came a week after friend Annabelle Nielsen collapsed and died aged 49 in Chelsea. Both were part of a London set that included supermodel Kate Moss and fashion icons Isabella Blow and Alexander McQueen, who both killed themselves in the past decade. Lucy Birley, the former wife of singer-songwriter Bryan Ferry, pictured together in Hyde Park in 1995, has died on holiday in Ireland at the age of 58, right with her now ex-husband in 1981. Lucy Birley married again in 2006 after falling in love with Robin Birley, pictured together at Kew in 2013, the stepson of the late Sir James Goldsmith and son of nightclub king Mark Birley. Mrs. Birley was last photographed at the Cheltenham Gold Cup last year, pictured, and died on Monday, a week after fellow socialite Annabelle Nielsen died suddenly aged 49. Her death came a week after friend Annabelle Nielsen collapsed and died aged 49, and both were part of a London set that included fashion icon Isabella Blow, who killed herself in 2007, and supermodel Kate Moss, pictured at London Fashion Week in 1993. Lucy was close to her four boys, pictured here with sons Otis and Merlin at Cheltenham in 2011. Bryan Ferry said he was shocked and saddened by his ex-wife's death on Monday. A statement on behalf of Mrs. Birley's husband and her children said today, "On Monday Lucy Birley, née Helmore, passed away whilst on holiday in Ireland, surrounded by her beloved dogs, Daisy, Pig and Daphne." Bryan and Lucy Ferry in St. Peter's Square, Rome, in June 1982, shortly after they married. Her husband Robin, and her sons, Otis, Isaac, Tara and Merlin, are understandably devastated and request that their privacy be respected during this difficult time. No further comment will be given on the circumstances of her death, a family spokesman said. Birley and Ferry married in 1982 and they divorced in 2003. In 2011, Birley told The Guardian that she retreated from public life following the breakdown of her 21-year marriage to Ferry and for other personal reasons, including her son Otis' arrest and brief incarceration in a series of pro-hunting cases. She said, "I didn't want to be put in the spotlight. My family's attitude to the press and publicity was very much that it was frowned upon. You only appeared in papers if you were born, married or had died. That affected me when I got married to Bryan. I didn't want to reveal myself and, actually, probably there wasn't much to reveal at that point." Daughter of the late Lloyd's underwriter Patrick Helmore, Lucy was a successful model before she met Bryan Ferry. The former couple couldn't have come from more different backgrounds, with Ferry the son of a miner and she was the daughter of a man who made millions in the city. Lucy was well-educated and welcomed in the finest houses in London, with her family were linked to two baronetcies. A friend said when they split, she gave Bryan what he wanted more than anything else in the world, a touch of real class. She knew everything about the country pursuits that he identified with the aristocracy, and he learned so much from her. They got together after Mr. Ferry split with Jerry Hall after she found Mick Jagger. In her last major interview in 2011 she told The Guardian, "I was very surprised when I met Bryan that he was interested in going out with me. It seemed slightly surreal, I suppose. They married in 1982 and he toured the world with her husband. It was exhilarating," she said, adding, "I learned a lot from Bryan and met a lot of other artists I probably never would have met otherwise. I was very young and I was bowled over by the whole idea of touring and recording, and the world being open to you." Initially she was a stabilizing influence on her husband, but as he focused on his work she fell into addiction. She said, "I know I have an addictive personality. I grew up with alcoholism. My father was an alcoholic. It's genetic, partly. The couple, pictured left in 1986 and right in 1997, split but remained amicable, describing it as a working relationship, and met with their children. Lucy clings to her son. Notice at the 2007 funeral of friend Isabella below, the magazine editor and muse of hat designer Philip Tracy. Lucy, pictured left and right in 2003 after divorcing Bryan, was a model and photographer who said she drifted from Bryan Ferry before their high-profile split. Gaps between Bryan's releases reached up to 6 years in the early 1990s as he supported his wife. Before her death, she had been teetotal since 1993 after she was detoxed during a 9-week stint at Farm Place Clinic near Ockley in Surrey, helped her beat drink and drugs. Mr. Ferry said Lucy was the inspiration for much of his later music, and she appeared on the cover of his band's 8th and final album Avalon, albeit under a helmet. The following January, Bryan spent the new year on his own in Barbados, working on an album as he concentrated on his work. Within 10 years they had split, having drifted apart but still got on, she said, adding, we have a sort of working relationship to do with our children, but we don't see each other on any other basis. After their 2003 divorce, where she was reportedly handed £10 million of Bryan's fortune, she was romanced by Robin Birley, the stepson of the late Sir James Goldsmith, and they married in 2006. But there was a notable absentee on the wedding day, the groom's father Mark. Despite the couple's efforts to heal the rift in the bridegroom's family, Mark, the man who created Annabelle's nightclub, named after his ex-wife, failed to show up to support his son. Mrs Birley, pictured with son, notice after he left Gloucester jail after a pro-hunting stunt in 2009, stepped away from public life after years struggling in the limelight. Robin is the son of the late Sir Mark and Lady Annabelle Goldsmith, and the half-brother of Zach, Ben and Jemima Goldsmith. After their divorce, Bryan fell in love with Kate Turner, a dancer 35 years his junior, but they would split 6 years later in 2008. He then met PR woman Amanda Shepherd, and in early January 2012 they married in a private ceremony on the Turks and Caicos Islands. But 19 months later they separated. Their eldest son, Otis, spent some time in jail in 2008 after being charged with assaulting a Hunt protester. His mother said at the time, I am worried sick about him being in prison without any clean shirts or socks. For someone who loves the outdoors so much, it's very difficult to be in a cell without any windows of fresh air. 4 years earlier, Otis was among pro-hunt campaigners who stormed the Commons as MPs debated the hunting ban, which he described as futile.